few days ago, my beautiful wife, who wishes to remain anonymous, my son's best friend for many years, and my son went to a college football game. In a stadium that can hold 60,000 people, there was a record crowd of 58,000. We watched the first quarter, then the second quarter, in which I noticed a young woman, apparently not an avid football fan, gloriously engaged in a video game on her iPhone. Ominous clouds built up behind the stadium wall, but like a cowardly lion, they never acted on their swaggering threat. We watched the band march at halftime, and then the third quarter started. At some point in the third quarter, the natives became restless and initiated an imitation of the ocean as wave after wave broke across the nearly full 60,000-person terrarium. We witnessed and participated in wave after wave. Slow-motion waves, fast-motion waves, waves that swept in both directions at once, and I got a video of my feet. Then I noticed a peculiar occurrence. Across the stadium, 30,000 people had banded together into an alliance of one voice and had begun to challenge the 30,000 people on our side of the terrarium to a shout-off. They yelled out our team's name and we began yelling, "Power!" At first I thought this was a little like chimpanzees posturing across a river for dominance. Then it occurred to me. What I was witnessing was nothing less than peace. All around me were people of varying races and ethnicities. Looking around, I could see people from other countries, other religions, and people of different sexual preferences. There were old people and young adults, babies, children, and teenagers. And to a person, we were all participating in a two-word exchange in support of our team that battled like warriors between us. No one was killed. No one was beaten. No one was even spoken against. It was, for a moment, a celebration of peace, a 60,000-person playpen, and we were all having a ball. Maybe, just maybe, we could take all of our differences in this world, put them in a football, and pile all of those in contention in this beautiful blue-green ball of mud randomly lost amongst a trillion stars, and for a moment, we could all chant in unison to see our differences crushed beneath the brightly shining weight of our team of divergent similarities. In the words of the great sage and master songwriter John Lennon, imagine all the people living life in peace. The next time you walk down the street and encounter someone who is different, I would ask you to smile, say hello, and wish them peace. God bless you all. Have a great day. Bye-bye.